Hello and welcome to another exclusive and official Harryhausen unboxing. This time it's Medusa from Clash of the Titans.
One courageous man rides between an angry heaven and the fury of hell on earth. He rides a winged stallion across the sky. He rides to save the one who owns his heart. He rides towards wonders no man has ever seen and terrors no man has ever faced. Clash of the Titans.
Medusa is a character from Greek mythology and normally appears as a robed figure with snakes for hair, although Medusa only appears in Clash of the Titans for around 4 minutes. Her character dominates the film and the poster artwork. Before Ray Harryhausen's Medusa design in 1981, we were used to seeing Medusa on screen in films such as George Pal's The Seven Faces of Dr. Lowe and The Gorgon from Hammer Films, both in 1964. Ray wanted to get away from this human figure depiction of Medusa and decided to give her a snake-like body, which he carried on through the rest of the styling for the creature. We saw a forerunner for this in Ray Harryhausen's 1958 classic, The Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, when the evil magician Sakura, played by Torrin Thatcher, combined a snake and servant woman to impress the Sultan. Star Ace Toys have a detailed model of this on the way soon too. Ray Harryhausen took inspiration for the face of his Medusa on a classic Hollywood beauty, but he kept the secret for years. He revealed to me years later that it was actually Joan Crawford whose dramatic and piercing gaze made her a legend of the silver screen and an ideal candidate for Medusa. There was only one model Medusa made for animation filming, but there was a full-size head that gave some animatronic movement after she is beheaded by Perseus and held aloft to the gods for their approval. Watch closely and you can see her eyes open as she is held to the heavens.
Find and fulfill your destiny.
This is not just one of the greatest Ray Harryhausen sequences, but many believe it's one of the most iconic and greatest images of cinema in the last century.
The scene with the Medusa in the labyrinth is absolutely incredible. I think it's the finest piece of work he ever did. And it's a masterwork of lighting, of animation, and of drama.
Medusa was a very interesting character to work with, although very complicated to animate. For each frame of film, which is 1/24th of a second, you had to move 12 snakes in her hair, the heads and the tails of each snake. Then you had to move the hand. Then you had to move the arm. You had to keep the body in synchronization with the rest of the torso, with the tail, with the rattle.
The shooting script revealed an alternative and more gruesome end for Medusa, and you can see some of it in the Lookin magazine special tie-in that came out in 1981. Lead time for color comic book graphics meant that they had worked from an early draft of the script. After a fight with Perseus and his men, Medusa was to have been beheaded with a frisbee-style throw of Perseus's magic shield. After some animated discussions with actor Harry Hamlin on set, it was decided that Perseus using his sword would be a more historically accurate demise. You can read more about this and other missing scenes and unmade films in my book Harryhausen, The Lost Movies, which is out now. In the US, film censors worried that Medusa was going to be entirely naked, which for a family film would pose problems. Ray created an alternative sketch, and this rare image from the archives shows the model with its chest covered. European censors worried about the graphic beheading of Medusa. In the end, the darkness of the scene and the dramatic intentions of the story save the film from the censors' scissors. Because of the extra time pressures on Clash of the Titans, Ray brought in Janet Stevens, who had worked with him on Sinbad in the Eye of the Tiger, to work on sculptures for both the Kraken and Medusa.
The Medusa character seems to be one of the favorites of many fans that have written to me. Some of the early films, they just took an actress and put rubber snakes in her hair, which looked rather artificial when she walked. They just all bounced in unison. And I didn't want that, so I had to redesign her so that she had a serpentine body. But every statue I'd seen, she was just a woman with a pretty face and had snakes in her hair. Well, that wasn't very dramatic, so I gave her a rather demonic look. We gave her a rattlesnake's tail so that she could be a menace from the sound effect point of view. It had flickering fire, and in order to make Medusa, who was put in later, look like she was part of the scene, I had to put a flicker on her all the time, every time she was seen. Janet Stevens was a very good sculptor, and she's worked with us on several films. I would draw the figures up, and then she would model them in clay. And Janet did a marvelous serpentine texture of scales on Medusa. She manufactured this ball-headed lady with a serpentine body, which we made a mold of, and then cast it in rubber over an armature made of metal that would be flexible and movable.
Rather fittingly, Medusa has needed very little restoration over the years and stands resplendent in the archive of the Ray and Diana Harryhausen Foundation. Right, let's get unboxing. The boxes here, of course, are always a joy to behold. Christopher Nico from Rain Studio has been involved in designing this entire range, and again has created a wonderful box design for this piece. Christopher told me how he wanted to make the name Medusa prominent with black background, granite texture, and spot UV gloss printing effect to make Medusa herself stand out. Christopher cleverly uses a different rock texture to represent her power to turn men to stone. For the box colour, he's used a combination of black and gold to symbolise her evil power of darkness, but the allure of gold which draws both the soldiers in and us, the greedy public. Ray Harryhausen, of course, on the side, responsible for all of these creations. Let's get this opened. Inside, this is a super vinyl figure, so it's got a form of vat-formed plastic surround. Incredibly secure, look at that. As we pop her out, she's a single piece. There's no parts of the anatomy to pop together here. And very nicely packaged. Look at that detail and that incredible pose. A Ray Harryhausen style pose. Of course, the folks at Star Ace work closely with us here at the Ray and Diana Harryhausen Foundation to get these as accurate as is possible. Now, this particular sculpt has, of course, come from the Kaibotsuya Studios. But also this time, they were aided by the sculpting skills of Joe the Doughty. Incredible, the detail here, the facial expression, and of course, the terrible stare of Medusa. And those snakes appear as if they are moving. I know they're not, they don't move on this particular piece. Comes, of course, with a set of instructions, as these always do, with the bow and arrow set. Let's look at that. Now that comes apart in two pieces and then fits snugly into Medusa's left hand. Clicks together quite nicely. You can see now on the back we can place in two additional arrows and they have registration holes. They fit in nice and snugly. And there you have it, almost. There's one thing missing, of course. The hero arrow, which clips nicely into her hand, into her right hand there, and sits gently across the bow. The detailing here, the colouring here, is absolutely superb. And this is, I think, one of the best sculpts I've seen from Star Race Toys. Of course, because it's Star Race and it's a luxury piece, we couldn't let Medusa escape without something additional. What's this? We can see from the silhouette on the side, it is Medusa herself. Inside, it's in foam, so it must be poly resin. Our old friend here for the diorama base. This base is very unusual. Look at that. A soldier that's been felled by Medusa herself, who's crumbled into stone. And even has a stone snake around his neck. Beneath, Ray Harryhausen's Medusa Deluxe version. You can buy this separately, of course. Now, absolutely incredible. This doesn't just come with a figure, it comes with this, a fire brazier. How incredible the detail on this. It looks like it's real fire lapping the flames. An incredible detail here on the bronze effect around the feet. Hold a brazier there, sat proudly on the plinth next to the soldier, and Medusa in place with her prey at her feet. So reminiscent of the classic scene from Clash of the Titans. For those who've thought about buying the full sets before, getting the diorama here I think is pretty much essential, because this is not just a footplate, it's a real character piece that goes with this Gorgon, the Gorgon that is Medusa. So there we have the footplate, the brazier, Medusa herself, the wonderful box designs, and now it just leaves us with an on-screen comparison. Let's go. Was epic. Now you can see other Clash of the Titans unboxings on this channel with the Kraken, Pegasus, and Bubo the Owl. And you can find out more about the Ray Harryhausen Foundation at rayharryhausen.com, where you can find our social media links and of course our podcast too. Now if you'd like to win your very own Medusa figure with diorama base, then simply subscribe here and comment below the video if you dare. Good luck, and we'll see you next time.